Magandang magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. Would you turn around and say hello?
Hello!
Hallelujah. Today is the day that the Lord has made. And since yesterday, albeit holiday ako hanggang ngayon, and praise the Lord. Our speaker has been in Hong Kong for many times already. He was born in September 3, 1961. So kasing edad ko siya. Graduated from Manila Baptist Bible College.
Okay.
We are having a friendly Baptist minister today. Okay. AB Theology in 1990, graduated from International School of Theology in 1998, and right now, ongoing doing his Doctor of Ministry in the International Graduate School of Leadership. Wow. My friends, ladies, it is my pleasure to introduce to you the Reverend Sarlito Alex.
Thank you. Good morning.
Good morning.
Thank you for that kind introduction. Sabi ko po sa kanya, to be honest with you, pili ka na lang dyan, Pastor, kasi ano yung appropriate. I was not really expecting that he's going to read everything. Eh, alam nyo, kapag binabasa na lang yun, naliliit na ako pagkain. Well, anyway, kaya lang, habang ako'y naglalakad dito, parang may lang sumisigaw sa akin ng Pachoy, Pachoy, Pachoy. Anyway, I'm really glad to be with you. I'm really good at Pentecostal Ben. Really, may nagtanong dyan, ano? Pentecostal ba yan? Yung Pentecostal po ako. Kombinasyon yan, lahat yan. At ako po yung nag-aagalak na maging kabahagi ng gawin. Actually, I'm a part of the different ministries. That's what I'm going to show it again to you. Leave it to the expert. Okay, and... Oh, wala pa. Here's a pass. Leave it to the expert. And again, let me introduce to you from the Philippines, my Miss Universe ng buhay. Ayaw niya sumama, sabi niya, I'm going to miss that, ano, that, kasi bukas yun eh, di ba? Yung bukas pa, yung pinaka-final nila. Bukas yun, di ba?
Bukas.
Sabay na sabay yun. Anyway, I've been here since 2000. And that is why I was so encouraged to accept the work of the Global Filipino Movement, because for so many years I've been working with OFW. I've been with churches here all throughout the Hong Kong. So mula sa Kowloon side, Hong Kong side, sa New Territory, been here for. And at isa lang ang lagi ko narinig, pag ako nagpupunta, noon di pa uso yung mga cellphone, mahal yan eh.
Amen.
Diba? Pagka makikitawag din ako sa mga telephone booth, and usually sa mga lugar na maraming telephone booth, you'll find a lot of mga kababayan natin doon. Kung may apat doon na telephone booth, you will hear different stories.
Yes.
Makikigil na dito meron tuwan-tuwa, dito may galit na galit, dito. Dito halos gusto patayin niya na yung kausap niya. Different stories. So I've been hearing a lot of this, and that is why OFW ministry is not really foreign to me. I've been working with you for so many years, and not only here, but in different parts of Asia also. At sa marami pang lugar po, mga kaibigan, mga kapatid, mga kauturan, kapsat ka pa rin, at pati na po rin sa ating bayan sa Pilipinas. But anyway, you are called unsung heroes. Pag sinabi natin mga OFWs, you were given the title unsung heroes, mga heroes. Because heroes always entails a lot of sacrifices, if not martyrdom. Diba? Well, the other day, one of our OFWs was executed in Kuwait.
Kuwait.
Si Pawa. I'm thinking that she is from Mindanao also, also a Muslim, but was executed in a Muslim country. So, and so that is really a sad state. And some of you are, one of the reasons why you're called heroes is because you're bringing a lot of dollars in the Philippines. Yun yung common denominator. But we all know that that is very costly, right? You are spending a lot of days, minutes, hours, and years, even years. And we know that there is always that pain of separating from your loved ones. Isa yun sa mga sinasakripisyo ninyo eh. So that you will alleviate the pain of poverty. So that you will help your family. Yan yung common denominator natin yan. And so, ang goal ng Global Filipino Movement is actually one, yung mga papunta, pigilin huwag lang umalis. Pigilin huwag umalis. Sabi niyo, apaka-corny naman ni Pastor. Hindi naman ho. Kaya lang, we know the consequence. Absentee parenting will always cause some troubles of family. Now, I'm not saying this to actually say mali kayo, whatever. Let me finish. No? 75 to 85%, as far as the World Vision's survey that they did already, 85% medyo may problema lagi yung pamilya ng kwento. Because you cannot deny the fact that absentee parenting or long distance relationship is always causing some trouble. You know very well, mayroong mga anak na naging addict, may mga anak na naging maaga yung pagbubuntis. Hindi pa ang problema, hindi pa malaman kung sino yung ama.
Hallelujah.
Tapos yung pamilya na I have seen this one. May pamilya dito, hindi pala dito. Doon sa Middle East, may pamilya doon. May pamilya rin dito. Doon sa... Yeah. Well, that is why we are telling them, are you prepared for this one? Pag sinabi niya, talagang hindi na ako mapipigilan. Alam niyo mga Pilipinong gusto mag-abroad, parang si Miguel eh. Di ba? Habang pinipigil, lalo nang gigigil. Hindi gusto... And then the second thing that we are offering is to help them prepare as they go and proceed to their country of destination. Tutulungan namin maganda. Prepare hanggang kailan, paano kayo magsisave, talk to the family. That's the purpose of Global Filipino Movement. And at the end of the day, we want a kababayan to proceed to wherever he is and be used by God in transforming nations, both the Philippines and the place where you are. We can consider by divine providence, we can consider you by divine providence, by God's sovereignty, as one of the missionaries that God can use. Right? So you put this in your mind. Hindi ko sasayangin ang pagpunta ko sa Hong Kong. Hindi ko sasayangin sapagkat pakikinggan ko pa rin at susundin ang mandato ng Panginoong Jesus na humayo at gawing alagad ang buong nasyon, ang buong bansa, hindi lang ang Pilipinas. So please, don't waste that opportunity. Don't waste that opportunity because God has given you that mandate. Every one of us, wherever we go, daladala natin yung mandato na yon. Lahat ng masalubong mo, lahat yan, nangangailangan ng Ebanghelyo ng Panginoon. And even the most hated employer ninyo. Of course, hindi lahat. Marami ka rin maririnig na kwento ng mga employers sa ganyan eh. Pero hindi naman lahat. Marami naman mababait din, di ba? Bisa na, sa tagal ko dito, lalo na pag ganito mga holiday, isang papasok na ako dun sa tinutuluyang kong flat. Yung mga ganyan, nakatambay ko. Ba't ayaw niyo pong pumasok? Antay lang muna kami alas 10. Hindi niyo pa yung alas 10. Pasok na kayo sa inyo para mapagpahinga kayo. Hindi nga ako eh. Pag pumunta kami sa loob niya, utuso na naman kami. Utuso na naman kami ng mga yan. Kaya sasagarin na namin yung station kahit nilalamok at nilalamig nung sa laban. They will stay outside. But listen. Those are actually opportunities for us to show the difference between non-Christians and Christians na katulad po natin. Tama ho ba yun?
Amen.
Right? So, let me introduce you again, yung pong, yung nauna po, yung po yung aking involvement ngayon, Global Filipino Movement. And at the same time, I'm involved in the training of pastors and church leaders. Ito po ay through Foundations for Christian Leadership, a non-formal training program for pastors and church leaders, which is a ministry of International Graduate School of Leadership. Baka ho may nagpaplano sa inyong umuwi na. At gusto niyo mag-aral, magpatuloy na pag-aral. Welcome na welcome po kayo dyan. Okay, makipag-ugnayan lang po kayo kay Pastor Wendell. And then also, yung pong ministries na ito, Jaron Ministries, same thing, involved in pastoral training. And then I'm also pastoring Southern Light Community Church in Beer Homes, Parañaque. And this is my lovely family.
Wow.
Pwede ko ba introduce ko sa inyo?
Sure.
Kaya sabi ni Pastor, mga tatlong oras daw ako dito. And of course, ano ba pointer dito, Pastor?
Ito? Sa side niya. Ayan, ayan.
Ba yan? Baka kasi mapindot ko, pumutok ito. Of course, nadagdagan na kami ng dalawang apo.
Wow.
Ayan, at ito po yung aming panganay. The Lord just blessed him to be invited to teach at Vietnam. He's now the swimming coach and instructor ng isa sa mga Australian International School.
Yeah.
So that's his lovely wife. Together, the whole family will be together in April. Now, I'm saying this for some reason, okay? This is my second son, si Carlo. And he is also with our Global Filipino Movement. But he's a more of a marketing guy. Okay, he's a marketing guy. This is my lovely daughter. Favorito ko po yan. Elisa. She finished her journalism in Manila Times. And then went and studied in Taiwan. Pagbalik niya, she was with GMA Network. Medyo maganda, no? Maganda talaga. And then, nung mga parang April, sabi niya, pa, I think the Lord is calling me to the ministry. Sabi ko na, delikado yung insurance ko. HMO, di ba? Si beneficiary kami. Lahat na ganyan. So, she's now studying in Singapore in East Asia School of Theology and taking Christian ministry. So, sabi ko, parang ano yan ah, kasi medyo, hindi naman sa pag-ano, medyo may kalakihan yung salary niya sa GMA. E tapos, wala. Ngayon, by faith na rin eh, parang sumama na sa akin. Pero I'm really glad because she witnessed how the Lord provided to us.
Amen!
And parang sa kanila, parang hindi nakakatakot yung if they're going to leave this and leave that because they have they experienced God for so many years.
Yes.
And that is our bunsot, si James. And he is a DJ. Mamayang gabi, 9 to 12, try niyo pong i-google yung Save Radio 106.7, the best in Christian music, 9 to 12. Ito yung Christian program, FM. Sila yung in charge ng pag-handle ng mga Hillsong, si mga panagko-concert, Hillsong, Planet Shakers, at saka ano pa ba yun, mga si pambata yung mga yun. Napakaganda po, 9 to 12, just listen to that one. So yan po ang composition. Now why am I showing this? My family is, I'm always showing this to everyone kasi they are a living testimony of God's faithfulness to us and to even to you.
Amen.
Kung magkakaroon lang tayo ng tinatawag na patuloy ng pagtitiwala. Okay ba ako naririnig sa likod?
Yes!
Right? So, as I look at, as I've shown to you the different hats that I'm wearing, ang laki ng trabaho. The task is great. PCEC and the churches that is involved here in PCEC, we have posted a goal of establishing 120,000 churches by the end of 2020. Ang laki ng gawain, di ba? Ang laki ng... Kaya lang, hindi lang yun. Hindi lang particularly sa ministry. But even in our personal lives, we are facing a lot of difficulties sometimes, a lot of trouble. Let me ask you this question. Have you ever faced in your life a very difficult situation that seems to be impossible to her. Nagkaroon ka na ba ng pagkakataon sa buhay mo na kung saan, paano bang, naku, ano ba naman buhay ito? Kabi-kabila yung mga sitwasyong hindi mo maiiwasan. At laging, ewan ko ah, pero ngayon, lagi nakakatakot na makareceive ng mga tao mula sa Pilipinas. Hindi, yung excitement, paano bang, lalo na kapag alam mong may maraming problema, pag, sasagutin ko ba ito o hindi? Well, anyway, difficulties are always around and you cannot deny it. I was in my navigation class during my college day. Nabanggit niya that I finished my nautical science. Prayer to, ano po yun eh, hindi pa ako Christian. Pangarap ko na maging kapitan ng barko. At my young age, kasi linya ko kami ng mga marino. Mga uncles ko, mga, kasama mga lahat-lahat, halos yan, puro halos kami mga marino. So, ambisyon ko na po yun. And I know how they earn money. Kaya pangarap ko rin eh. So, kung magkaroon ng maraming sasakyan, maraming bahay, maraming bahay, maraming... And anyway, during one of our classes...
May bahay.
Now, during one of our classes, I remember one of our instructors, he's a third mate, third officer, and he was sharing to us his experience here in Hong Kong when papasok sila dito sa Victoria Harbor. During that time, miski naman ganyan eh, ang lalaki ng mga barko dyan, di ba? But you know, when they're about to enter this Victoria Harbor, hindi naman sila natatakot sa malalaking barko. He was so bothered by this wala-wala. Or this sampan. Ano yung sampan?
Yes.
Yeah, that's yung mga houseboat. Yung maliliit na bangka. Ang dami! You know, if you are, at that time, if you are the watch, o yung pinaka na officer na in charge, the last thing that you're going to do is to call the attention of the captain. Kasi may oras yan eh, 4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 4. Walang oras dun yung kapitan. Ang kapitan, 24 hours yan na nasa cabin, paigunin, pakapikapin, pagkakapin. Yeah, yun lang yun. Pagka may operation at saka lalabas, sigaw lang ang sigaw yan. Yun ang trabaho ng kapitan, kaya gusto ko yun. Anyway, and if you are part of the crew, if you are the officer on watch, the last thing that you want to do is to call the attention of the captain. Kasi parang kumbaga sa ano, bawas pogi point yun eh. But anyway, he found it so difficult to maneuver the ship because of the heavy traffic. So, although it was so humiliating for him, he decided to call the attention of the captain who was resting then. Kasi madaling araw eh. So, he called up at sinawagan niya, Cap, pasensya na po, but we have some situation here. Sige, sabi ng Cap, bababa ako. Okay, punta ako sa bridge. We call that as bridge, yung monkey bridge. So pagdating doon, sabi niya, Kap, sensya na po, pero tinuro niya yung sitwasyon. Nag-iikap pa yung kapitan. You know what's the first thing he said? Hindi niya malimutan niya. Simple mo lang ang kape. siya naman, official din siya, no? Pero very humiliating, punta ka doon sa isang lugar, timpla ka ng kape. You cannot see from the captain any trace of panic. Any trace of worry, but there is a trace of seeing things, everything is still in control. He is still in control of the situation. And the next thing, isang salita, dalawa, tatlo, nakita na lang niya, nakatawa ka na yung barko. You know, very humiliating, but let me tell you this, what the third officer did was the right thing to do. He was in trouble. He was actually in trouble because he doesn't know what to do. But you know what he did? He went to the expert.
Yes.
And the expert did the best thing.
Amen.
The point here is this. When the expert took control, all became well.
Amen.
Listen, I believe one way or another, we have experienced the same thing. May mga pagkakataon sa ating buhay na parang hindi na natin kaya, hindi na natin kontrolado. We face the impossible, we face a lot of impossibilities in our lives. it seems like para bang we're going to cross the uncrossable river, the these high mountains, or maybe just like David, we're facing Goliath. I don't know your situation, but I am very sure as I'm standing here, many of us are facing difficulties. But let me tell you this, when we are facing difficulties, leave it to the expert, leave it to him. Leave it to the expert, leave it to him. May mga bagay na parang sinasabi ng Panginoon, timpla mo muna ako ng kape. Akong bahala dyan. Are you with me?
Yes.
So this is actually what happened to our two apostles that have witnessed, have encountered the similar difficulties in their lives. So I'd like to invite you to please turn your Bibles with me from the book of John, chapter 6. And we will be reading, we will only be reading verses 5 to 7 for a background. But let's read verse 1, okay? In order for us to see the background of this one. John chapter 6, verses 1 to 7. We'll be reading verse 7. After these things, Jesus went away to the other side of the Sea of Galilee, or Tiberias. A large crowd followed him because they saw the signs which he was performing on those who were sick. Then Jesus went up on the mountain, and there he sat down with his disciples. Now the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was near. Therefore, verse 5, Jesus, lifting up his eyes and seeing that a large crowd was coming to him, said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread so that these may eat?" This he was saying to test him, for he himself knew what he was intending to do. Philip answered him, 200 denarii worth of bread is not sufficient for them, for everyone to receive a little. May the Lord bless the reading of his word. Let's Amen. Go to him in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, and Lord, we surrender even our lives to you, our minds, our hearts, and even our hands, that we will be able not just to hear what you're going to say to us, but apply, do whatever you're going to instruct us this morning. Lord, I pray that you're going to guide us, give us wisdom, and give us the courage to fulfill what you want us to do. For this is our prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. All right. This passage we have just read is a very familiar one. We call this as the feeding of the 5,000. This is a very unique story because aside from the resurrection of Christ, this is the only event that you can find in the four Gospels. Lahat dyan nakalagay. So please take note doon sa binasa natin kanina. How was the narrative started? It started with the word or phrase, after these things. After these things. Pag nakabasa ka niya sa Bible, after these things, then that requires you to read the previous passages or chapter para maintindihan mo ano ba nangyari noon. Alright? Ano ba nangyari noon? So, the gospel writer actually had written a lot of incident about Jesus Christ and his miracles. Right? Yes. Yung, alam niyo yung water into wine,
yes,
the healing of the blind man. Ang dami. And so everyone now is hearing about the Lord Jesus. And because of that, they want to follow Jesus and they want to have a piece of the Lord Jesus Christ. They want to do at least experience what others were experiencing then. Jesus Christ was so popular. Was so popular. And so, sa dami ng mga nakarinig, nakabalita, nagsunuran sila lahat. Right? Eh, napakarami po. At sabi nga doon sa ating istorya, sa binasa natin kanina, Jesus, lifting up his eyes and seeing that a large crowd was coming to him, said to Philip, "Where are we to buy bread so that this may eat?" I would like you to imagine with me kung gaano karami yung sumusunod. Right? The answer of Philip was very true. Sabi niya, this he was saying to test him for it. Philip answered, 200 denarii worth of bread, is that sufficient for them? You know what's 200 denarii? That's equivalent to 8 months' wage. 8 months. Magkano ba yung sweldo natin dito? Mga palagay mo, mga 20,000. 20 times 8. 160,000. ganun karami kailangan nilang pera nung panahon na yun. At bakit ganun karami? Because when Jesus saw the crowd, ilan yung pinakain niya dito? 5,000 ang binilang. Yung 5,000 na yan, mga lalaki lang yun. Eh kung kasama pa yung asawa, di ilan na? 5,000 times 2, di 8,000. Na ganyan. 10,000. Ano ko lang kung nakikinig sila ba? Eh may kasama pang isang anak, ilan na? Ilan na?
15.
Eh kung may kasama pang isa pang anak, kung dalawa,
20.
You would like to imagine how really difficult the situation was. 20,000 na katao pakakainin mo. Alam niyo ba kung gaano karami yung 20,000 na katao? Have you seen Araneta Coliseum? Punuin mo yun, ganun karami yung 20,000. That's how popular the Lord Jesus Christ was. And everyone wants to have a piece of the Lord Jesus Christ. But Jesus Christ so beyond what their needs. Kita niya, nagugutom na yan, katulad ng iba sa inyo. Sabi niya rito, sabi niya, nagtanong siya, where are we to buy bread so that this may eat? There was that compassion. Pero meron din siyang reason why he asked this question. What was this he was saying to test him. To test him. The question was not just a question. It was a question to test their faith. So what did Philip do? Philip do an immediate computation. Parang iba sa atin. Parang mga statistician. Ulang ho, wala ho tayo. Paano ba yung iba sa church? Meron tayong project. Ang tanong lang yun, may budget ba dyan? Meron ba tayong pera para dyan? Tandaan po natin ito. Kagawain ng Panginoon, laging meron.
Amen!
Ito lang, magandang galing sa inyo yun.
Amen!
Amen, ha? Pagdadaanin sa inyo ng Panginoon.
Amen!
Anyway, Jesus, he knew very well the situation, but he is here to test the faith of these two apostles. And anyway, si Andrew, let's look at another passage. Si Andrew, let's read the next passage dito. Verse 8. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, dalawa kasi, si Philip, and then here comes Andrew. Are you with me?
Amen.
All right, huh? Verse 8. One of his disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, there is a lad here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish, right? Yeah. So when he heard Jesus asking, where are we going to buy bread? You know what Andrew did? He tumingin na siya. Paano nga ba tayo makakakuha ng pagkain? And he saw one little boy. Yung little boy, you could imagine that little boy, lumakitang tinitingnan yung pagkain niya. May limang tinapay at saka dalawang isda. So he immediately did something. Kumilos siya. Kaya lang, yung next statement niya, betrayed his little faith as well. He said, there is a lad here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are these for so many people? Ang sasabi niya, Panginoon, meron dito eh. Kaya lang ang dami. You know, when Jesus asked that question, where are we going to buy bread? What do you think Jesus is expecting as an answer? Hindi ko alam. Talaga namang yun eh. Tama ba yun? Hindi ko alam. Panginoon, kayong nagdala niyan dito eh. Problema niyo yan. Kung tutusin, di ba? These people are following you. Wala ko tayong pagkukunan. Kaya nga sabi ni Philip, 200 denarii reward. Hindi ko kakasya. At saka sarado na ngayon yung McDonald's. Kasi tanong niya, where are we going to buy bread? Ano? Ang bagay na ganyan. Anyway, nung sinabi niya, meron na ditong bata na may dalawang tinapay. Limang tinapay at saka dalawang isda. Anong sabi ng Panginoon? That's enough. Let them sit down. Because in the eyes of God, the little things in the Lord's hand is enough so He can demonstrate His power.
Amen.
Listen, it is always yung inadequacy natin, yung kakulangan natin, yung kahirapan natin, yung simpleng pangangailangan natin, doon mo lagi makikita ang dakilang kapangyarihan.
Amen!
Sometimes, pag meron tayong napakarami nating pera, napakarami nga, minsan hindi natin makita ang kilos ng Panginoon, natatakpan yung mga bagay na yan. You know what we can learn from this story? Diba, pagkatapos niya magpakain lahat, ilan na sobra? In dalawang basket. You know what we can learn from this passage? We can get three learnings here. We can glean three learnings here. And in this learning, you will find that if it is impossible, go to the expert. Lift it to the expert.
Amen.
Let's go to the first principle po natin. Impossibilities are part of Christian experience, so expect it. Expect it. Don't you ever believe na ang buhay Kristiyano walang problema. Sinungaling po yun. Dahil unang-una, alam natin na meron tayong mga problema. Feeding the 5,000 is an impossible task. But it happened. As believers, we will always find ourselves encountering situations like that. And this situation, we call this as challenges. But the problem with these challenges is, if they are not handled properly, it will drag us down spiritually.
Yes.
Pag hindi po natin natutunang i-handle ang mga difficulties, yung mga challenges, yung mga troubles sa ating buhay, maapektuhan tayo, pati na rin yung ating spiritual growth. There will be times that situation before us will look like an absolute impossibilities. But take note, ha? Even the doctors who said, hindi na mo namin kaya yan. Anong sasabihin nila sa mga may sakit? O anong sasabihin sa pamilya? Isa na lang ang pwede pagpagaling dyan. Diba? Even non-Christian doctors will tell you that there is one who can really do the impossible thing.
Amen.
None other than our God. Now, basing on our own understanding and evaluation, it will be a difficult one. We may be even tempted to pray that God will not allow it, but we find it the other way around. Let me tell you this. Pag may mga difficulties, pag may mga problema, it creates fear in our lives. But let me tell you this. There is nothing wrong with fear. Fear is God-given emotion that tells something is wrong, and we need to go to someone who can help us.
Yes.
That is the idea of fear. Fear came from the word phobeo, which means to run or to take a flight. Lumayo. Diba, nagbagsak ng ahas dito. Wala naman yung parang nagbagsak ng ahas, dadamputin lahat natin yung ahas, diba? What happened when you throw a snake here? Tatakbuhan. Fear will actually visit our hearts and we will run away. That's the idea of fear. And that is a God-given emotion. Fear is a good visitor, but don't allow it to stay as a resident. Because when it becomes a resident, pag yan tumira na dyan, it will cripple you, it will paralyze you. Fear is God-given emotion for you to run away and to go for certain shelter or refuge. Yun ang gusto ng ating Panginoon. The moment you feel that one, go to Him.
Amen.
Pardon me for this, not even to your pastor, not even to your church, not even to your best friend. First thing that you need to put in your mind, if there is something wrong, go to Him.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes, Lord.
Go to Him.
Yes.
And let me tell you something about difficulties. Sometimes we face series of great opportunities brilliantly disguised as impossible situations. Kaya alam isa, pag nakita na natin difficulties, aayawan na natin. No. They are part of our Christian life. Expect it. And I'm very sure the moment you get out from that, overcome that one, you're going to experience wonderful things in your life. Sometimes we want to be spared. Ayaw natin dumaan. But the only way for us to really overcome that one is to pass that way. Right? And that is one of the ways in order for us to really grow in our faith. Pag dumating lahat ng uri ng troubles, and I know we're experiencing this one, sa tagal ko ng pag-visit na papunta rito, pag nagkakantahan na yan, makikita mo na dyan sa isang sulok, may umiiyak, may umiiyak. Alam mo na, may problema yun. Alam mo na, umiiyak yun dahil tuwan-tuwa. Alam mo na yan, may trouble yun. Kung pwede nga lang lapitan isa-isa. Meron bang iba sa tawa ng tawa? Sabi nga nila, yung mga malakas magsalita, maraming problema yan. Yan yung mga nagtatago ng kanila, mga kung ano na rin. Dinadaan nila sa pagsasalita, lahat ng mga bagay na yan. Kaya mapasin nyo, so mamaya tahimik lahat. And anyway, kapag dumating yon, sabi nga ni James, welcome them. Sabi na, count it all joy when you fall into various testings or trials. Pag dumating yung welcome lang namin. Eh, pastor, ang dami. Sige, papilahin mo. Ito, isa lang. But what I'm saying is this, don't be surprised if we have difficulties. That's part of Christian life. Expect it. But how are we going to overcome that one? So we go to our point number two. Impossibilities allowed by the Lord are opportunities for us to exercise our faith. Trust me. Trust me. As I've said earlier, impossibilities are heaven sent, meant to test our faith. What we can see here that would really illumine our mind is that we need to accept the facts first, of the reality of these testings, and second, the fact of our limitation. The fact of our limitation. And because of that, as I've said earlier, the moment they come into our lives, we need to turn to the Lord and say, Lord, I don't know how to do this one. Lord, I don't know how to make this one. Lord, I don't know how to overcome this one. Minsan may mga issue tayo na mga mahirap matanggal, di ba? I don't know about you, but give it to the Lord. I'm sure the Lord will honor your faith. Huwag talagang binigay mo mga bagay na ganyan. Leave behind statistics. Leave behind computation. Okay? And please, refuse to worry. Refuse to worry. Don't worry. I don't be happy. Don't worry. Yung sinabi ni Paul sa Philippians 4:6, be not anxious in everything. Be not anxious. Or in other verses, do not worry. Ibig sabihin, mag-worry pa lang nagkasala ka na. Pag sinabi yan, do not worry, you have the capacity to do it. Hindi ako mag-aalala. And the only way for us to do it is to accept the fact that these are realities and I can always go to someone who can handle all these things sa buhay ko. Right? We can always be like the deck officer. When we found na medyo tagilid tayo dito, we can always go to the expert. Now let me say, share you some encouraging passages. In Jeremiah 32:17, let's read it together. Ah, Lord God, behold, you have made the heavens and the earth by your great power and by your outstretched arm. Nothing is too difficult for you. Nothing is too difficult for you. Listen, have you realized this one? Na lahat ng sinasabi nating difficulty sa kanya yun ay?
Nothing.
Whatever difficulties we are facing to the Lord, it is?
Nothing.
Wala. Wala yan. Sa salita natin sa Pilipinas, sisiw lang yan sa Panginoon. Wala yan. Right? In verse 27, it says, behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is anything too difficult for me? What's the answer? Is there something difficult to the Lord?
No.
Now, let's reread this while substituting your impossibility. Sabi niya, is your problem with money difficult for the Lord?
No.
Is your illness difficult to the Lord?
No.
Is your problem with your husband difficult to the Lord?
No.
Hindi mo lang alam, Pastor. Eh. No, lahat ng sagot yan, no.
Yes.
Walang mahirap sa Panginoon.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying here? We're facing difficulties. We look at that difficulties. We magnify that difficulties. Then we don't see God anymore. Parang ito yung difficulties. Ba? Ang laki-laki ni God. Andiyan, oh, my God is indeed big. But the moment mag-focus ka dito, it covers my God, and now I'm focusing sa problema. That is literally what is taking place in our lives. We are magnifying the difficulties instead of seeing the God, that our God, that can actually make these difficulties even look like a simple situation. In the New Testament, nothing will be impossible with God. Luke 18, 27, these things impossible with men are possible with God. He's the expert. If you are in a difficult situation, go to him and leave it to the expert.
Amen.
If it's a difficult situation and you cannot do it, go to him. He will help you on those things. Na sinasabi ko po, may mga bagay kasing kaya naman natin gawin. Gawin na natin. Pero pag dumating yung panahon na parang hindi mo na kaya, talagang hirap ka, you can always go to him because he is always there.
Amen.
Let me go to point number 3. Impossibilities allowed by the Lord are chosen time to demonstrate his power. So praise him. You know, this is one of my favorite Sunday school stories. Apa na tuturo kami sa Sunday school niya, kumpleto sa mga mga parapernalia, so, I would like you to imagine that time. Remember, binilang natin how many people were there? 20,000. Kahapon, we planned Pastor to go to Victoria, binaba kami ng aming host doon sa may pick trunk, sinisasakyan siya. Pagkakita pa lang namin doon sa mga tao, alam, parang ini-imagine ka na, kung ganito karami na dito, sa taas siguro, sa damakmak ang tao, no? Parang hirap maglakad na, hirap maghanap ng upuan, yan. So, sabi ko doon tayo sa baba, naku, ang dami pa rin. So, nag-end yung, umuwi na lang kami. Nangarap pa naman ako, magkukwentuhan kami mag-asawa doon, mag-ahawa ka ng kamay, mag-itingin. Habang nakakwe ka, nangangarap ka na ganyan. We really planned for that, not sa Manila pa kami. Kaya, inulit ko pa sa kanya, talaga bang ayaw mo nang pumunta doon? Yeah. We've been there for so many times naman eh. Kaya lang, para sa akin, very important yun na magkasama ulit kami doon. Anyway, wag na lang, ang daming tao eh. Kaya pag maraming tao, it always gives you a parang aura na ang hirap nito, ang dami niya. Can you imagine those guys? Pinapaharap ng pagkain pa sa 20,000 na katao. Wala pang fast food ng pastor, by the way. So gagawin nila lang, kukuha ng arena, magkagagin niya. Wala noon. Diba? Wala. So you could imagine the difficulty at that time. But anyway, sabi niya, nung makita niya yung limang tinapay tsaka dalawang isa, sige, paupoy na sila. Very orderly, pinaupo niya, pula, sama-sama na ganyan. Tapos kinuha niya yung tinapay. By the way, you will not appreciate the 5 loaves of bread and the 2 fish if you're not going to look at yung ika nga, kung anong uri ng isda. Hindi ito katulad ng mga salmon, ha? Yung mga pero actually, in this incident, this is like a piece of sardine, parang tuyok sa atin. Dalawang piraso lang yun. Kaya nga siguro tinitingnan ni Andrew, sabi nung bata, nag-i-increase. And then the 5 loaves of bread, if you've been to Middle East, meron silang tinatawag, it's not chapati, I forgot the ano.
Obos.
Obos or whatever. So yun yung niluluto sa unan, sa mainit sa oven. Yan. Ngayon, ang problema, this kind of bread, pagdating ng hapon, brittle na.
Matigas
na. Yan. So, you could imagine, they started in the morning, sikat si Jesus, yun natin, hapon na yun, paggabi na, kaya sabi niya, pakainin eh. So, medyo malutong may, no? 2 fish, and 5 loaves of bread. Medyo makunan na. Well, anyway, sabi niya, paupuin lahat. Upo na sila. Tapos, kinuha niya yung basket ng tinapay. Sabi siguro ni Philip sa kanya, ano ba yung gagawin nito? So tinaas, pinasalamatan. Tapos binigay niya kay Philip. Doon sa apostle sa kanya. Sige, distribute niya. Parisip-sip niya. 20,000, limang tinapay. So binigay muna yung isa dito. Napanayan tawa. Sabi siguro, praise the Lord now. Tapos binigay yung isa dito. Ayan. Ilan na lang? Sumisigaw na yung nandun sa likod. Paano naman kami dito? Tapos binigay kay Pastor, ano? Dahil medyo parang masama ng tingin. Dahil kasama niya yung misis niya, binigay dalawa. Sabi nung naroon, patay tayo. Ilan na lang?
Isa.
Isa na lang. At tapos lumapit sa isa. Sabi nung lahat, wala na. Pero kumuha pa rin. Lumubot pa rin. And to their surprise, may lumabas sa kinapay. At isa pa. 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 At sabi ng ating story, everyone was fed and they have an excess of 12 baskets. 12 baskets. Alam mo ang Panginoon pa nagbigay? Tandaan niyo to, ha?
Amen.
Daging may sobra.
Amen!
It's, kaya namin siya hindi tayo marunong mawag ng sobra. Hindi sobra, piligagad, no? Naalala ko yung kwento nung kasama. Alam niya, meron siyang sobrang mga parang 12, mga 20,000 na nakuha ng ganyan. Kaya pili dito, pili po. Tapos after one week, tumawag sa kanya, kailangan natin ng, naku, Lord, kailangan ko po na po. Sabi ni Lord, naibigay ko na advance. Kung anong pinagbigay ko nito. Well, anyway, the point here that we can see here is this, right? Your little is much when placed in God's hand.
Amen.
You know, sometimes you are thinking, hindi ako magagamit ni Lord, hindi ako marunong mag-English, hindi ako magagamit ni Lord, mababa lang ang edukasyon ko, hindi ako magagamit ni Lord, wala akong gift na ganito, wala akong... You know, listen, God will not look for something that you do not have.
Yes!
Anything that you have, yun ang hahanapin niya.
Amen.
Sabi ni isa, kung meron lang ako 1,000,000, magbibigay talaga ako. Eh, wala ka naman yan eh. Anong meron ka ngayon sa bulsa mo? Ay, wag naman yan, Pastor. Meron talaga ako eh. Wag mo nang pangarapin yung 1,000,000. Yung 100,000 dyan, yan ang ibigay mo. Dahil kung anong meron ka, yun ang gagamitin ng Panginoon.
Amen.
Kung kaya mo ay ganitong klaseng English lang, it's raining, aren't we? Okay na yun. Hindi naman alam ng mga naririnig ng English ko ang tama o mali. Sabi nung kausap ko, sabi, nagalit sa akin yung anak ko yung si Carlo. Ba't ba tinatagalog mo sila? Eh, intisin ko man yan, hindi naman ako maintindihan yan. Nahihirapan ko pa yung sarili kung mag-iingis. What I'm saying is this, listen. Don't you ever tell to God, you have nothing. I'm not bragging in this, ah. Yung panganay ko po, tsaka yung pangalawa ko, almost all of them, puro scholar sila. Not academically. Nung naging Christian po ako, I'm already a, marunong ako lumangoy. And as I look at them, Pastor, sabi ko, alam ko mahirapan lang akong pag-aralin sila. Not because I have a small God or what, but I know it's going to be difficult. So I need to discover ways in order for them. So I know how to swim. I brought them to the swimming pool, to marunong akong lumangoy, and then I brought them to a club. Bata pa yun. Sabi ko sa kanila, you will use this one time. Pagdala ngayon niya. So nagko-compete sila. Mga edad pa, 10, 11 ha. Mga coaches na sila. So during summer, may income na sila. And not only that, high school pa lang, part na sila ng varsity ng kanilang school. So libre na sila sa pag-aaral. All of them went. Except yung bunso. Yung bunso nag-apply ng mag-isa eh. Nabigyan ng scholarship ng St. Bilil. 5 years. Bayad lahat. Sige. Parang ganito. Numili ka tayo ng Panginoon, meron siyang paraan para mangyari yung dapat mangyari. All we need to do is, God, paano ba ako nilika? Anong meron ako? God has given every one of us talents, gifts, exceptional qualities that God can use you. Do not look at yourself and say, ganito lang ako eh. No, 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 no. no. God has in store something for you that God can use you anywhere. That's what I'm saying kanina, mga kapatid. Ba? Yung kanina, binabanggit ko kanina, kayo na rito because God wants to have a wonderful ministry with you. Gawain na kayo. Sub-mention kanina, if it's impossible, leave it to the expert. I mentioned earlier that we have a great task. And sometimes we are parabang disappointed tayo. We have a lot of troubles in our lives. Sometime in late 60s, merong dalawang singers, duet sila, that composed a song that became so famous. I'll try to hum the song, ha? Try to name the tune. Folks, listen. Realities of our lives are like that. Sometimes we are, seems to be crossing troubled waters. Daming problema, daming sigalo, daming mga paasanin, and as we look at that, para bang sabihin natin, wala na. But you know, we have a bridge over the troubled water.
Amen.
And that is our God.
Amen.
That is our Lord Jesus Christ. Don't you ever forget that. Mahal ka ng Diyos. At hindi niya nais na kailanman makita mong parang maliit siya. Our God is a big God.
Amen.
He takes care of everything. Just leave it to Him. Leave it to the expert.
Amen.
Let's bow our heads and close our eyes. While every head's bowed and eye closed, I'd like to take this opportunity. Is there someone here who seems to be crossing an uncrossable river? Who seems to be facing a Goliath in his life? Who seems to be facing some difficulties in his or her relationship? Or family problems or whatever? Seems to be facing the impossibilities. Would you please raise your hand and I'll be praying for you. Thank you for that. Salamat po sa pag-ayon. Oh, thank you for that. Thank you for that. The answer is not me. But the answer is Jesus. Jesus has all the answers. So my challenge to you this morning is to simply commit it to Him. Leave it to Him. Leave it to Him. Our Heavenly Father, we come to you this morning, thanking you, O God, for this opportunity that you have given to us. O God, you have seen the hands of those people, these brethren, Lord. You have seen the hands raised. But I believe, Lord, not only the hands, but you have also seen the heart, the mind, and even the situation of these sisters in the Lord, brothers in the Lord. And so, Lord, please, grant niyo po, Panginoon, ang pagkilos sa aming kalagitnaan. At kayo po, Panginoon, ang manguna sa kanila, na isuko nila ang kanilang, ano man yun, Panginoon, I do not know all those things, but they can always surrender it to you. They can leave it to you, Lord, because you are the expert. Whatever they are, O God, in Jesus' name, we commit them to you. And Lord, even this morning, we are even claiming the victory, knowing, Lord, that nothing is impossible.
Yes.
Be it money matters, be it family matters, be it employee-employer situation, Lord, nothing is impossible for you. And that is why even this morning, O God, we are now acting accordingly. We are going to live victoriously because we know, Lord, you are our God, you know everything, and we can leave everything to you. For this is our prayer. In the mighty name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and all God's people said,
Amen.
Good morning and God bless you.